Welcome to Who's in the Bible, a podcast for kids. I'm Eric.
And I'm Lance.
And we believe that the Bible is the greatest book in the whole world. It's filled with amazing stories about interesting people, all working together to tell a bigger story, the greatest story, about the most important person who ever lived, Jesus.
And we know that understanding more about the people and stories in the Bible helps us to know more about Jesus and what it means to be his followers today. And in this episode, it's a season one recap.
Oh, yes. Man, we made it.
We made it. Season one, all the way through Genesis chapter 50.
That's a big book.
That's a giant book.
I will say some of the other ones later are going to go a little quicker than Genesis.
That's true. Yes.
But man, so much has happened.
A lot has happened, and we thought we would do a recap episode to talk about all of season one, some of the highlights, some of our favorite parts, and what to expect a little bit from season two.
Yes. A little preview.
So, Eric,
yeah,
what were some of your favorite parts about season one of our new podcast, Who's in the Bible?
You know what? When we were first talking about this, I was like, when I was thinking Who's in the Bible, I didn't think that we were going to just go with God.
Yeah.
Like we just started with God.
We did.
Yeah, we went God, man. I was like, whoa, cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we got real specific there. Like, if we don't have God, then who cares who's in the Bible?
That's right.
We don't have God. But some of the interesting things, like, I mean, you know, I grew up reading the Bible. When you get into the Old Testament, so I think as a kid, sometimes things were odd, and I remembered certain people. But just some of the details were pretty crazy. Like all the cousin wives.
The cousin wives.
Pretty interesting.
I really enjoyed our That's Just Weird game shows.
Definitely. There were some very odd, weird things that happened in the Old Testament. Lots of brothers wanting to kill each other.
Yeah.
For stuff.
Yeah. Here's the thing. You can, a lot of the time, people don't talk about the weird stuff in the Bible.
Yeah.
I love to talk about the weird stuff in the Bible. God put it in there.
If God put it in there, he made it for us to know.
That's right.
That means it's important.
That's right. Also, there's a lot of stuff in the Bible that isn't weird. It's just difficult to understand. And so that's one of the things I enjoyed was thinking material.
Yeah.
Yeah. When we can stop for a minute and say, oh man, I need to think more deeply about this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I hope that's something you guys have even done over this season, that you actually have pushed pause from time to time and gone, that's interesting.
I
need to think about that a little
bit
more. Another thing that I think that I really hope has happened, I know it's happened even for me as an adult, is there have been moments and times, things that have come up in my everyday life with my family or with people that I know or that I interact with, where things that we have talked about on this podcast that God has done in the Old Testament in Genesis have actually made sense in my life now. And I've been able to talk about it more clearly because of the things that we've talked about on this podcast. That's kind of been more readily available in my mind.
Man, that's pretty cool. One of the things we hope for you kids that listen, that as you learn the Bible, it's not just knowledge for your mind, but that it would help you to know God and to live as one of his people.
Absolutely. What's like one of your favorite things? I'm every now and then, I still get a little woozy from the time travel week.
Oh, the back in time bus.
Bleh.
Oh,
I can
man.
Still smell that yeah. village.
Oh, gosh. That was a trip. That was definitely a trip. But you know what?
Definitely a trip.
We may have to make another trip in the back in time bus in the future.
I still got the app downloaded.
Okay. Man, yeah. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Yeah, definitely for true.
Okay, we covered, like you said, episodes about God and people, and then specific people like Adam and Eve and Cain and Abel and Noah and the flood with this big floating zoo. And
I forgot about that one.
Tower of Babel, and then Abraham and Isaac, and man, so many stories, but it was really cool.
It's amazing.
Here's one thing we wanted to do, is to kind of think back on all of the episodes we've done so far as you kids have listened and as we've gone along. What are the big things that we hope that we've all learned as we've gone through this? So, Eric, what's the first thing for you that comes to mind that like we need to know about?
I think the thing to grab onto, like if you're making your short list, is that since God made it all, we start in the very beginning with God created, right?
Yep.
So since God made it all, it's his.
Yep.
He's in charge.
That's good.
God is in charge.
God is in charge. He is, man, he's over everything. He's our king. He's trustworthy. Mm-hmm. All, yeah, that's really good. I'll tell you, next for me is God's love. I think in one of the early episodes, we described the Bible. If you could wring it out or squeeze it like you do an orange, what would come out is the love of God, because it's just on every page. And I think we've seen that even when people are terrible.
Yeah.
God continues to love them. When people make mistakes, he shows grace. When people go through difficult things, God is present in their life and works it out for good. Like, God loves, even though we're sinful, and he wants to be present with us. That's pretty cool.
And so the last thing I would say after that is, like, you know, who, what did you even just mention just then? Is that God shows his love to a people.
Right.
Is that God has a people. And we saw that when he began that promise, that new covenant with Abraham, you know, that then he is weaving this story together, and that he has a people.
Yeah. And it's through this people that God wants to rescue and bless the world. Mm. It's not just that he wants to have people, but he plans to use them. And so, in the book of Genesis, we've got the very beginning of this story. If you have a Bible at home and you're listening, like, you know, Genesis is just like the first little part, but the story of God's people plays out for the rest of the Bible. And I'm looking forward to season two as we get to go further into that and see what happens with God's people. Because, spoiler alert, it's not just a family once we get to the next book, Exodus.
It's going to be a nation.
A nation of people.
Yeah.
Yeah. If like, we're going to fast forward 370 years. It's wild. I know. So this family becomes this great nation, and then we're going to hear their story, because where we left off, they're in Egypt.
That's going to be awesome. I mean, I can't wait.
Yeah.
I hate even having to wait, but you know what?
It's good.
We need to do it.
We need, yeah. We're going to start recording these episodes and get them ready for you. We're going to have many more creative elements, and it's going to be so cool to keep going through the Bible. And it's so cool because we really do believe it's the greatest book in the whole world, and it's telling this huge, great story that leads to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Man.
I'll tell you what. You have been listening to season one of Who's in the Bible, brought to you by Clear Creek Community Church. So why don't you do this before this one ends, before we can celebrate season one, hit that subscribe
button.
Because once you've hit that subscribe button, as soon as season two is ready to roll out, it will automatically notify you, and you can start jumping in with us as we begin to plow through the book of Exodus
and beyond.